So, Susie prepared some slides about dependency injection. Maybe we'll start again with a short, how to say, with a short test. Who is familiar with dependency injection here? Who could explain it? Maybe both.
But Tom can't explain. So maybe.
Okay, so please come up. Alrighty.
You still have the microphone, so you need to continue talking.
I knew it. So we are a bit unprepared, but I guess we will manage to do it. So first of all, we want to talk about what is dependency injection. Secondly, we want to talk about why we use it, or why I want to use it. Well, obviously, then we want to talk about when to use it, I guess. And in the end, how to use it.
In type 3.
In type 3, yes, of course. So I guess maybe all of you are familiar with the with XSpace and the dependency injection in XSpace, aren't you? Okay. So I guess you all know that in type 3.10 we will have dependency injection core wide. So you can have you can inject your dependency everywhere. Did you know this? Yes. No. Who didn't know it? You. It's too sad. Okay, because you wrote a blog post about it. Okay. Okay, so you want to start?
Give me the
microphone
thingy. I'm trying to talk into this. No, please don't. So let's start with what's dependency injection? I started with the most obvious point, dependencies get injected. It's great. By another object, or sometimes called container or service container, it's basically passing the dependencies from the outside in. Who of you is familiar with the solid code principles? Okay, that's fewer. There's something called inversion of control, and dependency injection is one way to implement that. It's basically providing more flexibility, clearly stated dependencies in your class, and makes your code easier to test by, if you have a general utility make instance all over your controller, for example, you have like 500 lines of controller, don't do that, please never do that, and you have like 20 general utility make instances in there, it gets really hard to figure out which dependencies your class has. If you use dependency injection and have those in the constructor, and you have 20 dependencies declared in the constructor, you can take one look and see that's crappy code, let's throw it all away. Yep. Hello.
Yeah, we have to share. Sorry. And I'd like to add, if you refactor your code, let's say you have this 300 line controller and you have 30 make instances in your class, and you refactor it and put all this in your constructor, you maybe, you might realize that your class is too complex. So it probably does a lot more than just one thing. So if you see your object as a service and the service has one purpose, then that is, well, I guess it's not right. You did something wrong here.
Your service. We are currently recommending throwing everything away, and you are doing it wrong.
No, that's not what I'm saying. But if you have a class that is like a God class and does various different things, and you have so many dependencies for different tasks, then you could, well, maybe split up your classes in different services. Mm-hmm. So that's something you realize if you browse your code and see all your make instances and refactor it. Well, obviously, you don't see it now because, general utility make instance hides this complexity away, pretty much.
Okay. So when we use dependency injection, we are using dependency injection for services, ideally for singletons, stateless classes, and service-like objects, and not for prototype objects.
Do you want to do your prototype versus singleton thing?
Do we need to do this?
Who doesn't know what a prototype is?
What's the difference between a prototype and a singleton?
Everybody knows that. That's perfect. So we don't have to do that. It's now usable in Typo3 out of the box everywhere and based on Symfony dependency injection. Who knows Symfony dependency injection? That worked. So the reasoning is that more people know Symfony dependency injection already, so how to configure that and stuff like that can be looked up in the Symfony docs and we don't have to write them ourselves. So another good one. And we are using it in a way that's fully configurable, but usually you don't need to do much because it's automatically done for you. And I think the interesting part of this session is the next slides, because now we are looking at code. Hopefully we are looking at code. Can you see that? Can you read that in the last? Okay. So we have the most simple example ever. In a way you probably already know. We are injecting a service. We are in, in English?
Via.
An inject method, which is now usable everywhere. So you can also use that in non-X-based context. And then we have the same example, nur brain. Just via constructor injection. So we are using the constructor and Symfony dependency injection component analyzes that and injects the service. So basically property injection in XBase I think still works.
Yes.
But don't do that. Just don't.
Please don't do that injection methods too.
Yes.
It's just bad habit. It's
go for constructor injection.
So yeah,
do that.
Basically, you don't have any consistency in your classes. If any of those inject methods fail, you're in an inconsistent state.
And now we can look at the configuration.
Which I don't know.
Okay. So I'm going to continue to talk. It's fine. That's the basically it's the Symfony dependency injection configuration. So we have a YAML file where you define services and you have defaults that you can set. For example, autowire, autoconfigure, and public. And this is taken as default for everything you define here. And then you have some special things like if you have interfaces, you can define which class will be resolved to which interface. I have another longer code example, which I stole from somewhere. So you remember these two lines, the last two? Please read the last two lines and then keep those in mind. This is like memory. And now we have this class and this constructor, which gets the A and B services injected because of the configuration we saw before. So we have, does this thing have a laser pointer? Somewhere. So we have this variable here and this configuration. Okay?
Does it mean that all dependencies that are using alternative functionality, the alternative functionality variable name and the functionality interface will get those B instances injected? Or is it on a per usage base, per dependency base?
This is for the for this configuration scope.
Oh, so scopes are coming soon.
Soon. Okay. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe not. Yeah, it's a camp. Please don't diss my slides.
Sollen wir vielleicht auch zurückgehen und das mit Pubby und Outer Winding und
dann go?
Ich könnte das jetzt nicht so ganz gut erklären. Also ich weiß, was ist Public Faults, könnte ich erklären.
Yeah, go.
If this needs to be explained, I don't know. Do you understand these lines, this auto wiring, auto configuration and the
no,
public?
No, please go away.
Yes.
Do it.
Tell us, please.
You can do it.
Okay, so I think this is a global configuration here for the whole dependency injection container. And I will start with the public part. So the container will scan on all your classes, and it will register all your singletons, all your services in the container. And this public false means that you cannot access these services. You cannot get these services from the container directly. It's important because we are used to have a, well, at least in the XBase context, we are used to have the object manager available, which is kind of the same principle. And we are calling the get method on this to get our objects. And this is not it's not possible, because we will not allow this globally wide with the core dependency injection. So what this means, you have to use your constructor injection or your method injection. And you can't use the container directly. Okay, is this clear? Or you don't say anything, are you live?
No, so it's an anti-pattern to use as the dependency object container as a service locator, so don't use it.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. So I cannot really explain the difference between auto-configuration and auto-wiring, but...
Do you want to read the Google post?
No. Can you, or we can switch it?
And so we can I'm usually confusing these two, that's why I look that up every time.
Yeah, so do I.
So, auto-wire... What? Tommy, you said you could explain that,
no.
And you didn't want to.
I'm not the expert.
So now I have to read it. I'm not the expert either.
So you are giving a talk.
Now I'm totally.
But it's really simple. The auto wire is just for interfaces. If you have an interface,
but
and you are injecting the interface, you get, and you have only one concrete implementation of this interface, you're getting the right dependency. That's auto wire.
That's actually auto configure.
No. Configure has something to do with the text.
At least the documentation
no.
States that. So. So. That's why I'm confusing. This is exactly what happens to me every time. It's on the. Let's just explain both together, because then you have just the explanation. Basically, one is. Reading the doc comments and figuring out which classes to inject automatically and defining that, and the other one can automatically tag services. So tagging a service is like, if we use the type of 3 context, we have something like singletons and singleton interface, and type of 3 tags every service that implements this interface with the tag, it's a singleton. So the container can automatically react to that. So if we go to the advanced configuration stuff, this is probably the example. I can't read my screen. We have exactly the singleton interface. So we have a register for auto configuration, singleton interface, which adds the tag type of 3 singleton. And then we can react to that in a compiler parse. So the compiler parse is when the container, the service container, gets built. And then we can react to that and do stuff with it. For example, this.
Any
Okay, basically what happens here is that we are looking at the tagged services, so everything that's tagged with singleton interface is found, and then it's set to shared and set to public, so we can fetch the singletons from everywhere, and it's always the same instance. So the handling for singletons we had in general utility make instance before is now done with the compiler pass in Symfony dependency injection. Okay? I can also try to zoom in, but I have no idea how that works. I have this one. It's PowerPoint. Yeah.
I'll try to zoom out.
I did it. Yeah. So basically, that's it. At least these were my slides.
Yeah. Maybe we can add some stuff.
You can add some stuff.
Maybe I try.
You can also just random open links.
You can do so if you like. So I guess one important thing about dependency injection is that we should get used to code against interfaces and not against I don't know if you say against in English here, but you should use interfaces and can you open this this example again with the two different so here in the constructor injection we have the same interface, but we can say we can define what to inject actually, which concrete object we want to have, but it's important that we use interfaces. If you inject a concrete object, then it's a code smell, because what you want to do is you want to have an object that has some behavior, not which is a specific type of object. So you want to know what you can do with this object, and it's not important which object fulfills this requirement. So in XBase, you've seen this for years now, we have an interface for almost every concrete implementation, and we don't have this yet in the whole core. And even in XBase, it's not always done right. But this is something that you are encouraged to do if you're using dependency injection. If you're using PHPStorm, for example, and you inject you annotate concrete class names and not interfaces, it will also tell you you shouldn't do it. So you should get familiar with using interfaces here. Okay. Maybe a little bit more on XBase. So I guess you realize that we are not so deep into the topic. This has all been implemented by Benjamin Franzke. I haven't even seen him in real life. So he's a shy guy. He's a brilliant but shy guy. And we merged this dependency injection stuff. And now we have to explain it. And we are also not so familiar with it yet. So. Sorry for it, but I try to explain what he explained to me. For example, in XBase, it's still the case that you can inject prototypes. That you can use. That's still possible. You can. We have still in XBase. We have via the object manager. We have the possibility to have dependency injection in prototypes. So we have, for example, we have the Uri builder, I guess, which is a prototype at the moment. Well, maybe not this example, but we have some classes that are prototypes and which have dependencies, and this still works in XBase because, well, it has to work because we cannot refactor all the code in a couple of months. But you should know that this will not be possible in the future. So this will be this behavior will fade out. The object container of XBase will die at some point, and you should whenever you use the object manager of XSpace directly, you should ask yourself, am I doing something wrong here? And the answer might be yes, like in most cases.
But it will be still possible in 10 to use the object manager, it's not gone.
Yes. No, it's not gone, it's still possible. So, yeah.
I've opened some random examples just to take a look at.
For the camera.
For the camera. So this is the most basic example of an actually XSpace extension configuration, and what you need to do if you want to use the core dependency injection in most cases in your extension, and this is it. So it's like 8 lines of code. 7. Anybody seen my mouse? My mouse is gone.
It's here.
I can't catch it. Alex, can you take the microphone because I need it in my hand?
Yes, sure.
So this is another one. And now you're probably standing in front of the screen.
Yeah.
Nice. this is another one where you can see how you can add text to services with which then other stuff is done. And I think you have that in XSpace too. Remember your patch?
Yeah, this is
I didn't really follow. Sorry.
Based upon its interfaces.
Yeah.
Autovirus is reading the constructor.
And I wanted to show something else, but I'm
this
totally unable to do that.
Stuff in of XSpace, so just the implementation.
Oh,
right.
Finally. Yeah. Let me check. So this is Yammer from XSpace. So now it gets a bit longer.
Yes.
So this is the one from XSpace, which is basically showcasing a lot of features. Already we have aliasing for an interface name, so you can inject the interface and always get this class. Or the same with the object manager. And all these. And in most cases, if you do something special, we have comments on that. So you can look up the services YAML files. But usually you won't need that. What you can see here is also how you can use a factory, but this is also basic functionality of Symfony dependency injection. For example, the cache XSpace class, front-end interface, and it doesn't really inject an implementation of front-end interface, but instead it uses the cache manager and calls get cache with the argument XSpace to get an instance of that cache. So what you can do here is you can define factory methods to create the objects.
For this extension.
For this file.
Yeah. Configuration there.
For these basically.
This is the
yeah. So
only for the file.
Yeah, we only have one file. So just the services.yaml gets loaded, so it's basically per extension. But basically this one is for that one. Mm-hmm. And in Symfony you can have multiple of these files and then there's more defaults.
I can use imports there, right?
Yes, and also
yes.
And first. So, okay, I can talk about that too, because this is nothing about dependency injection, but the core YAML file loader can use imports, relative imports now, and env variables everywhere. So everywhere we are using YAML, for example, in sites or in this one, you can use all these features. Yeah.
Maybe you want to explain what the arguments do.
the arguments are just given to the factory. So basically what happens is you inject front-end interface, and then cache manager get cache is called with the argument hash in this case.
How, because it's stated like cache.pages here, for example, and how do you tag when your, this looks like a tag, how do you use the tag or specify the tag in your particular class implementation? That your dependency needs not only the front-end interface, but the front-end interface, you can tag with cache pages, for example.
Trying to find the example.
Follow?
Yes, I can follow your question. I just don't know the answer from the top of my head.
Okay.
So I'm going to search for something that can be searched for. Maybe page section. So what are we doing? Yeah, well, and now we should have implemented it. This is just, yeah, but this is just the definition.
Oh.
I was searching for usage,
okay.
But I can't find one. But I have an idea. Look over the hard questions. Oh, who reviewed that then? It wasn't me. And I don't have internet.
Yeah.
Perfect. Yeah, anyway, this is how you can find out. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry for asking this question.
Yeah, no problem.
I'm used to it.
This hotspot is password.
Nuts. Can somebody tell a story while I'm
yes.
trying to
maybe
locate
more questions?
So basically, you can use all of the functionality of the Symfony service containers. So decorators are also possible. For example, to decorate something.
Yes.
Something else.
Not everything is used in the core, but it's the Symfony dependency injection component itself.
Performance impact of this.
Oh, it's so important.
Just wanted to
I'm just going to continue to hate Tom.
It's so important. So important.
Me too.
There still is a pretty big performance impact when the container is first built. So if you clear all caches, then the first run builds the container. But Benjamin is working on a warm-up thing.
Yes.
Script command. Yes, we know. Because currently, if you clear the caches in the type of 3 version 10, you will quickly see that impact. So it takes like 2-3 seconds to build.
Almost fast.
On a fast machine, yeah.
On my machine.
Could take longer.
Yeah, there was a guy who said on the channel, I have a Windows virtual machine, and every time I clear my cache, it takes me up to a minute to see anything. So I guess it depends on your hardware, pretty much.
And less cache clearing then.
Yeah.
Or disallow clearing the Symfony container cache in production mode.
I don't know
where
if it's possible.
Your cache is in production.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
We don't do this, no.
Never. Weißt du den Status von dem Patch?
I can look it up.
I talked to Benjamin these days, and he's aware of that. We need this this warm up command. So it's not in the current version, but it will be in the LTS version, of course. But he just became a father for the second time, and you know these guys.
Priorities.
Yeah.
We don't need contributors, we need content.
Uh-huh. Okay. Do we have other questions?
Why do we have set type 3 query settings to null in your service YAML?
In the XPath thing, I guess.
In the XPath thing, I guess. And I need to go back to the XPath thing.
You are in this class, in this.
What?
You are in a file.
This is core, isn't it?
This is core?
This is core.
Oh, yes, it's core, yeah, sorry.
Query query result and type of query sentence. All classes.
Set incompatible classes to null. These require runtime parameterized prototype instantiations, because they aren't compatible yet with the dependency injection container, because not all classes were rewritten to be compatible. So
I have to use an interface instead, right?
No. That's a usual prototype that has dependencies at the moment, but it shouldn't have. So all classes or all objects that manage a state, and well, a query does manage a state, a query result does manage a state, and the settings as well, they are not no services, so they shouldn't be injected. And at the same time, they shouldn't have any dependencies. So
no.
Tom has
no.
Another question.
No.
What is the advised way to create instances of prototypes now? Make instances too.
Yes.
Because of
The
overloading stuff.
Of the X-classing, yes, because of X-classing.
Your learning is not finished.
You can't get out.
And what was wrong?
No, that's fine.
I
wanted to just know what's the advised way of creating prototypes right now.
Yes. Yes, okay.
Because there was an object manager create method also.
Yeah, but still works, but shouldn't be used. Yeah. Okay. So, any more questions? I think you have tried to do. You want to share your conversation here?
That's just Sebastian didn't listen, and is still allowed to go.
Okay. So
yes,
should
everybody
we?
Everybody gets a trophy day.
So shall we wrap it up or? Yeah.
Wrap it up.
Wrap it up. Okay. Yeah. Thanks for being here. What to say?